Hi, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm today. I'm down here with my seedlings. It occurs to me I should talk to you about the baggy method. Now, instead of germinating seeds in trays like this with potting soil, the method you use with the baggy method, and I've put together a demonstration here, is you enclose them into sandwich bags. In this case, and I'll show you the footage here, all I've done is folded them over into a paper towel, spritzed it with water, enclosed it in the bag, and then placed it into the same conditions, the same warmth as other seedlings. The idea is that the baggy helps to trap the moisture, humidity around the seeds, and gets them to imbibe that water quickly. And if they are fast germinating seeds, that should hasten them to germinate quickly. So now if the baggy method is so good, why wouldn't I just start every seed in it? And you can see that I've started a bunch of seeds in open trays. Just like many other gardening methods, it has its pros, it has its cons. So let's talk about those today. Let's start with the advantages here. And you can see from the trays that I have in the back here that they take up a ton of horizontal space on top of my table here. And that's expensive space. If it's a heated space, if it's lighted space, you don't want to use up that space unnecessarily. And with the baggies, at least for the first few days, at least until you get germination, you can leave them in those bags and stack them almost in an unlimited fashion. You can start a lot of seeds in a very small amount of space. Now, of course, that is only very temporary. Once you have germination inside one of these bags, you're going to have to remove those seeds, and then they're going to have to expand into trays like these ones or some other growing situation. So temporarily, you're going to save yourself some space. It also does control that humidity around the seeds. Now, there are other ways to control that humidity. And in the background here, you can see that on this tray here, I've just placed it in a bento box or a Tupperware container that has a clear lid on it. I could do the same thing with plastic wrap. Over here, just like I do with my germinating or propagating with cuttings, I have a humidity dome that's over the tray. So there are ways to apply humidity consistently that isn't in a baggie, but a baggie is a very inexpensive way to do it. Another advantage is with the clear bags, you can see right through them. So particularly if you're using something like vermiculite or perlite or some other growing medium in here, you'll see that the seeds are germinating, or you'll see their little tails coming out or their little leaves starting up. That will give you a good idea of what your success rate is very quickly. So it's easy to observe it. Not quite so easy with the paper towel folded over like this, but you can certainly just lay the paper towel on top of the seeds and then flip them over for a quick view. Nice thing also, going back to that point of using vermiculite or perlite and putting these into a small space, is that if you're doing something like stratification or cold treatment, like I've shown in a recent video, you can stick a ton of these into the fridge all at the same time. Before I get to the disadvantages of the baggie method, let's see how it works. And you can see there's a little bit of a discoloration there. That's usually nothing to worry about. A little bit of algae growing on the outside of the bag, or just a discoloration from the seed coat going onto the paper towel. But let's see inside of here what it's done to the seedlings. Okay, I'd say that's a pretty good reaction for 3 or 4 days. And yeah, it looks like that discoloration on the paper towel is just some of the dark color of the seed coat moving outwards and sort of wicking into the paper towel. Let's look at the next variety. Okay, that's pretty good. I can see a couple of them are putting out their little tails, their first little radicals of the seeds. So I'm getting some germination on that one as well. I do see a little puff of mycelium, or sort of that white thready growth of fungus that might be growing out the side of this seed. I'm not sure if it's too advanced or if it's rotting the whole seed yet, but it is one of the risks of this method, is that enclosed in a bag with that moisture, it can not only speed the germination of the seed, but also speed the development of any rot organisms. And talking about space savings, this one here I just did between a couple of cotton pads, just in a very small sized baggie here. And let's see if that has been successful as well. And yes, even more so actually, I'd say it's a little bit ahead of these ones over here in the same amount of time. And then that brings us to our next concern, which is that the fine hairs of the root there are actually sticking into the cotton pad. And this is the next disadvantage of the baggy method, is that as it starts to develop, if it starts to touch that that paper towel or this cotton pad, that radical, that first root that comes out, will actually get entangled in there and makes it a little bit hard for handling. It can actually damage them a little bit for handling. So if I started them into something like this, and this is the bento box I did at the same time, just in plain soil, what happens is it automatically digs that radical down into the soil and it ends up where it belongs, actually growing roots into there. So, you know, having to transplant it afterwards opens you up to extra handling work when it's more tender, when it's actually a little bit fussier to deal with. Handling seeds when they haven't germinated very easily, handling seeds once they've sprouted, takes a little more delicacy, and you are susceptible to damaging them a little bit more. Now I want to compare the progress that happened in these baggies compared to what happened in this bento box, because what I was trying to do here is sort of simulate the conditions that I would have had either in an open tray like this or in a covered tray like the one I have under the humidity dome here. And so I've covered it, and let's see how it compares to what was inside of the baggies. And I can see that these are equally as far along, with the only difference being that that first root is going down into the potting soil, right where it belongs. This variety in this tray was lychnis, a very small seed, and likewise over here, these poppy seeds are super small and hard to handle, even at the best of times. I'd rather spend the time and space up front on sowing them directly into these plug trays rather than delaying, because that's what you're doing with your space requirements and with your handling requirements going into the baggie. You don't save the space forever, you just save it for a few days, and you don't save the handling, you actually make it harder because it's harder to handle them once they've germinated. All right, that's my summary of the baggie method. You hear an awful lot about it, but I don't tend to use it a lot in my growing just because I want to save myself on that fussy transplanting step after they've germinated, where I can damage those little seedlings, rather just put them directly into the trays. There are two times that I find it particularly useful. The first of those is when you're doing germination testing. If you have a big batch of seeds and you don't want to dedicate this space to it without knowing whether it will germinate quickly, then you put it into that baggie method. It's a quick way of checking the seeds before you dedicate that space and that handling. The second thing that you may use it for is for that stratification method. I talked about that in a recent video, where you put things into the fridge and give them a cold treatment, particularly in something like perlite or vermiculite. It's a nice way to fit a lot into that fridge all at once. You can put them into a little box together and pull them out and look, and it's clear so you can see whether you've got some germination inside the bag there. So that's another time where it's really, really useful. All right, I hope you found this to be a helpful video. If you have any questions, please drop them into the comments below. I'll see what I can do to help.